American baseball player Satchel Paige once asked a profound question, how old would you be if you didn't know how old you are? At first glimpse, what do you think Satchel Paige is talking about? Well, some special kind of people in our world find themselves alone and isolated and different from their mates almost since birth. This set of individuals are referred to as old souls, old in heart, old in mind, and old in soul. An old soul is a person who finds his or her outlook in life vastly different and more mature than those around her. Are you wondering if you are an old soul? Find out in this video, where I will be sharing with you 13 signs you are an old soul and think differently. If you are new here, consider subscribing to this channel for more awesome videos. 1. You like to think things through. One unchanging fact is that even the most impatient people will need to think things through if they are an old soul at heart. Old souls do not just make decisions or draw conclusions, they like to sift through things. When asked to share their opinion about something, they take time to thoroughly break down the situation in their head before giving their response. If you are an old soul, thinking things through is an essential aspect of your to-do process and it enables you to move forward in the direction most in sync with your mind, body, and soul. To you, not being able to think things through, even a little, leaves you feeling uneasy. And that does nothing to help. 2. You don't just go out. As an old soul, it is quality over quantity for you. You love to go out and have fun, but going out because others feel it is necessary or you are imposed to prove that you are not dull holds no merit for you. An old soul is very much unlikely to go out during festive periods because for them, it would seem like they are going out just because everyone else is doing so. Rather than go out during holidays, you prefer to take out in holidays. You'll happily spend money on those things that give you memorable experiences and widen your horizons. Going out just for going out's sake is pointless to you. Instead, you would rather save your time and money and do something of quality. 3. You don't like to be unnecessarily stressed. Old souls are not unduly dramatic. They don't want to draw attention to themselves just because it makes them feel alive. If you are the kind of person that appreciates the quiet and invite peace rather than putting yourself on the spotlight, then you are an old soul. This is not to say that old souls do not get on the limelight. It just means that they get on there for significant reasons. Old souls understand that productivity has nothing to do with being crazily busy or stressed, but everything to do with how well you utilize your time. So they are mindful about what you spend your hours doing and make sure you're doing something worthwhile and not just keeping busy for busy's sake. 4. You value deep connections. As earlier said, for an old soul, it is all about quality over quantity. You require a profound connection with those around you to feel any connection at all. Half-hearted friendships, surface-level relationships, and fly-by-night hookups are not your things. You value the essence of deeper friendships and long-lasting relationships as you give yourself wholly to those you trust. If you're an old soul, you're likely to have fewer friends. The reason is that you're not concerned about having too many friends. Your primary focus is usually on the depth of the relationship. It does not matter the number of friends they have, even if it's just two. As long as there is a deep connection, they are content. 5. You love learning. As an old soul, you always seek knowledge. Nothing keeps you going more than learning more about yourself, other people, and the world around you. For you, learning means growing, and growing is part of life. As an old soul, you approach learning from the understanding that it doesn't have to have a definite end, for example, a degree or certificate. Indeed, those things are considerable, but they offer a sense of accomplishment. But learning for you is a lifelong thing. The act of learning something new and wonderful motivates you, not the initials after your name or the pride that comes with topping the class. Hence, an old soul is versatile, learning about everything and everything. 6. You are not moved by fast fashion. A typical old soul will reason like this, purchasing the latest items, following others just to fit in. Where's the fun in that? To you, being a style chaser or tech follower is something you can never quite get your head around. Buying things to get into some particular class or as a form of show-off to others is not something you can imagine yourself doing. You may even own a Kindle or you may have an iPad, but now they sit there, gathering dust because a computer works just fine for you. You don't care whether you're an early adopter or a latecomer. You might get pissed when you notice other people using the same thing as you because you only do not fancy common trends. None of the things defines you, and you're okay with that. 7. You like to be around people that are older than you. Do you frequently find yourself in the gathering of the elderly? Do you enjoy other people's conversations? Do you seem to have a deeper connection with your grandparents? Well then, you're an old soul. As an old soul, you like to drink in the wisdom of the old, and you hang on to their every word as they tell you stories of their youth. You laugh at their descriptions of old trends and cry out the war stories. You reflect with them about long-lost loves and even listen to their pearls of wisdom. At a time when we seem to have less time for old folks and only appear to be among our peers, you feel like you're missing something. That's because you appreciate what they have to share. And let's be honest, you secretly wish you could go back to the good old days, a time when life seemed so simple. 8. You are intuitive. One of the most prominent old soul signs is an unwavering faith in your judgment. While other people struggle to follow the counsel of their inner voice or sometimes find it difficult to hear that voice in the first place, an old soul quickly tunes into their intuition and trusts it as a reliable compass to what is right. Consequently, you'll usually be drawn to people who fit with you and your values. Plus, you'll often pick up guiding signs from the universe that others would miss entirely. Also, your friends will benefit from you sharing your gut. 9. You are a great listener. Given the empathy, patience, and understanding that goes with being an old soul, it's conceivably unsurprising that such individuals tend to be great listeners. If you're an old soul, you won't push your suggestions in conversations. Instead, you'll give your full attention to the other person, weighing theirs carefully and working to see things from the perspective from which they are speaking. This often means that the friendship you have are close and emotionally intimate. However, there are times when they'll give unsolicited counsel. 10. You see the bigger picture. Do you tend to see things from the angles where many other people do not care to look? Do you always feel that there is more to things than how they reveal themselves, like a small cog in a big machine? Old souls realize that, though they are small, they are an integral part of life. They approach things and life in general from a higher perspective, knowing life is more than it seems, and there is more to what we see. As troubles confront the old soul, they see each as a passing cloud that will only reveal the sun once more. This helps lead them through life with tranquil nature. 11. You like to be alone. People with old souls need time to think and focus on themselves. Introverts are often considered old souls because they spend time reading and journaling and doing things that make them feel more alive. Instead of trying to blend with society, old souls live their lives the way they want and find peace by themselves. On rare occasions when they decide to hang out, old souls are usually picky with people they choose to spend time with and places they go. They don't like superficial relationships and overly crowded places, so they would rather be alone than to be with people they don't connect with. 12. You give great counsels. You might have noticed that people are always coming to you for advice. Apart from having the gift of counseling, their ability to provide reasonable counsels can also be attributed to their love for learning and being around older people. What makes you an old soul is that you take the time to talk to people when they ask you questions. You know how to listen for things that aren't said and look deeper into things. This enables you to see things others don't and say the right words to those who seek your counsel. Old souls are great confidants. They can keep other people's secrets, and that is another reason why people come to them for counsel. 13. Deja vu. Have you ever felt like you have experienced a permanent situation before? That feeling is called deja vu. As an old soul, you feel like your memories are fluid and sometimes they aren't always clear whether they are recent or relevant to you. People with old souls can tap into other sources of information periodically, and while it sounds a little voodoo-esque, it could be that those out-of-place memories are just from your previous life, memories of coming and going, feeling like you have been here before, and knowing what's coming next are all signs that you are in fact an old soul. Being an old soul is a gift. It's not something to be shy about. Great individuals like Robert Frost, Eckhart Tolle, Jim Carrey, Oprah Winfrey, and even Nick Jonas have been called old souls. So, be delighted when people call you ancient.